Hello everyone and welcome. Today we will discuss about different eggshell defects found in commercial layers. So I have included only selected eggshell defects in this video. So let's start. Poultry egg is a vehicle for the reproduction. It is also serve as a source of food for the human consumption. All eggs have three main parts, that is yolk, albumin and shell. So the egg quality is the most important price contributing factor in table and hatching eggs. So it is obvious that quality of egg is important from producer's point of view. And one of the biggest challenge for the poultry industry is to provide consistent quality eggs products to the consumers. So in the chapter, I have discussed different shell quality defects like shell-less eggs, soft-shelled eggs, corrugated eggs, cracked eggs, flat-sided eggs, pimpled eggs, wrinkled eggs, misshapen eggs, etc. So before going in detail about eggshell defects, we will just see the structure of eggshell. So usually shell weighs between 5 to 7 gram, which is 10 to 11% of total egg weight. So its main function is to protect the content of the egg from the microbial and physical environment. So it controls the exchange of water and gases. So eggshell composed of mainly 94 to 97% of calcium carbonate. The calcium content of eggshell is approximately 1.7 to 2.5 gram. So shell contains 0.3% of phosphorus, 0.2% magnesium, and in traces it contains sodium, potassium, iron, copper, and finally less than 2% organic matter consisted of matrix proteins and the shell pigments. So it is very important to maintain eggshell quality to reduce number of cracked eggs or increase the number of sellable or the hatching eggs and high number of viable day old chicks. Okay, this is a shell-less egg. This egg is laid without a shell layer. And these eggs are protected only by the shell membranes. A shell-less egg consists of yolk, albumin and membrane only. It doesn't have a shell at all. The egg contents are protected by outer membrane only and these are often seen in the pullets coming into lay. Some of the diseases like avian influenza, infectious bronchitis, egg drop syndrome 76, that is ED 76, and the deficiency of calcium, phosphorus, manganese or the vitamin D3 that causes the shell-less egg. The incidence of these eggs varies from 0.5 to 6% and they are commonly produced by pullets coming into lay, particularly by birds that have matured early and in older birds, especially those which are nearing the end of the laying period. If an egg is retained in the shell gland for too long, the next ovulation takes place at the usual time but before the previous egg is laid. Second egg may spend less time than normal in the shell gland and the result is a soft or shell-less egg. So in such cases, a hen may not lay an egg on one day but may lay both coated and soft-shelled egg on the next day. These are the corrugated eggs. This is characterized by very rough corrugated surface and these eggs are produced when plumping is not controlled and terminated. So this happens when the egg membrane is thinner than it should be, often as a result of double ovulation, that means two yolks, and having to stretch thinner to cover the extra egg contents. So this result in insufficient plumping of the egg, leaving a corrugated membrane onto which the shell gets deposited. So, the shell takes on a corrugated appearance as well. The excess calcium consumption is one of the major cause of formation of corrugated eggs. The another problem is when there is a defective shell gland, it may lead to the formation of corrugated eggs. It is often seen with hens recovering from infectious bronchitis. Poor nutrition, especially calcium deficiency and the vitamin D3 deficiency, also causes the corrugated eggs. The toxins like mycotoxins and heat stress
That also causes the formation of corrugated eggs.
This eggshell defect is due to the excess calcium deposition over the shell of the egg. You can see here the white irregularly shaped spots, which are the calcium deposits present on the external surface of the shell. And this is caused due to the defective shell gland. This defect is found when there are disturbances during the calcification of the shell in the shell gland. This defect is often observed when there is excess calcium in the diet of the laying hens. This eggshell defect is called as slab-sided or the flat-sided eggs. When two eggs enters the shell gland pouch, shortly after another, normal calcification is interrupted. The second egg will not be as complete as the first and may be flattened at the side where the eggs made contact, resulting in a flat or slab slide. Flat-sided eggs normally make up less than 1% of total production. So they are most commonly produced by pullets in early lay and may be the result of double ovulation or being held over an extra day in the shell gland. This defect often observed in diseases like infectious bronchitis, in the stress condition, in the crowding, or incorrect or changes in the lighting program. This is a pimpled egg defect. So these pimples are small lumps of calcified material on the eggshell. Some pimples can be broken off easily without damage to the shell, while others may leave a small hole in the shell. And the incidence of the formation of pimpled egg is near about 1% of the total egg production. So aging of the bird, poor nutrition and strain of the birds, that may also cause the problem of formation of pimpled eggs. The diseases like infectious bronchitis, infectious laryngotracheitis, even encephalomyelitis, they causes this pimpled egg problem. The presence of defective shell gland and incorrect or change in the lighting program during the laying period, that also causes the formation of pimpled eggs. These are the misshapen eggs, and you can find these eggs are too small or maybe too large. Sometimes they are round instead of oval, or they may be differ from normal shapes. Sometimes presence of immature shell gland, and some of the diseases like avian influenza, Newcastle disease, infectious bronchitis, or egg drop syndrome 76, or the stress and overcrowding that causes the formation of misshapen eggs. This is a wrinkled egg. When the shells have thinly creased or wrinkled surfaces, then you can say it is a wrinkled eggs. So the wrinkles can range in severity from a single small wrinkle to quite a few large wrinkles, as you can see in the picture. So the stress, infectious bronchitis, defective shell gland and overcrowding, that are the reasons that causes the wrinkling on the egg. This is cracked egg. This problem includes hairline cracks, star cracks or large cracks that results in a hole in the shell of the egg. So eggshell can easily be damaged after the egg is laid. So cracking is one of the most common reason for downgrading of the egg. So it may be due to either to an inadequate eggshell being laid or to poor handling, which may occur during collection, grading or the transportation. It is a common problem in older laying hens. So inadequate nutrition, that includes the calcium deficiency and vitamin D3 deficiency in the diet, or the problem of mycotoxins and heat stress, that leads to formation of cracked eggs. Sometimes mechanical damage caused by bird's beak or the toenails to the shell of the egg, that forms the breakage or the cracking of the eggs. The managemental problems like infrequent egg collection and rough handling are the major causes of the
cracked eggs.
I hope guys you have gotten complete information about some of the important defects found in the eggs. Thank you for patience listening.